we have a Polage, which is a combination of a polarizing light source and Polage. Those two words have been merged to form Polage, that can be viewed through these hand viewers that you may see some people holding, or these points here. This was created by Austine Wood Comarow and David Comarow, and the title of the piece is Human Connections, and I think it serves as a very good anchor piece for the entire new wing. It is about communications, and if you look in it, you will find everything from marks in the sand to the UN General Assembly to Gutenberg's Bible to bees that are dancing to communicate to each other. This, in a way, is the whole history of the electronic village leading up to our current media ecology, if you will.
It's November 10th, 1986, and we're awaiting the arrival of a contract that's supposed to come by Federal Express today. I started working on the drawing. I have a few things here already. The central image is a face, which I did from Kara's face, but it's supposed to represent human beings, all of human beings. I thought the main subject matter of the mural has to do with the history of communication, and communication as the extension of man's senses. But it also has to do with a new way of seeing, which is the theme of the new wing of the museum.
What's the hammer represent?
Well, that represents man's basic mode of doing work, and then he's extended himself by mechanical means, gears here, and then even further by means of the computer chip, the microchip.
That's great.
So this is all represents extensions of man's hand. And down here we have the extensions of the foot, the footprints turning into the shoe prints, turning into the tire tracks, leading to the Apollo lunar landing module, and then again the footprint of the moon. One of the hexagons changes by itself. It undergoes a metamorphosis because of a rotating polarizer inside. The bees turn into dancers. This was the idea that generated the whole format for this mural. When I started thinking about the theme of communication, I wanted to think of something in nature that could represent communication, some non-human form of communication. And I thought of the way bees dance to communicate the distance and direction to the flowers and what the quality of the nectar is, etc. So that gave me the idea of constructing the mural in the form of hexagons, because the hexagons, also being one of the few absolutely interconnecting geometric figures, is also a representative, a symbol of communication, a network. The keyboard curving up and back is to represent music, and over the keyboard is our represented sound waves. From behind the keyboard comes black and white film. The imagery in that film is the horse motion studies by Edward Muybridge. And then behind the black and white film is the color film, little pixels of color, which then gradually become Omnimax film with the images of the shuttle from The Dream is Alive. Right above the eye is Polaroid's first camera. And above that camera is an image representing one-point perspective, which is a device that was invented in the Renaissance to show depth, but it limits you to a single point of view, just like the camera does. But above that is Marcel Duchamp's nude descending a staircase, which was first exhibited in 1912, one of the first Cubist paintings, and a departure from that single point of view, incorporating multiple points of view in space and time, which of course ties into this Polage, which is another example of multiple points of view in space and time.